يا أيها الناس كتب عليكم الحج فحجوا، أو كما قال صلى الله عليه وسلم: صدق الله مولانا العظيم وصدق رسوله النبي الكريم، ونحن على ذلك من الشاهدين والشاكرين، والحمد لله رب العالمين. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. My honorable dear, respected brothers and elders, mothers and sisters, all praise is due to Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala, our creator, our master, our cherisher, our provider. We thank Allah Subhanahu wa Ta'ala for all the bounties that He has given us, and we send abundant salam and salutations upon our beloved Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Ibrahim alayhi salatu wa salam, he was ordered by Allah Subhanahu wa Ta'ala to build the Kaaba. And the Kaaba, after it was built, Allah Subhanahu wa Ta'ala then commanded Ibrahim, "O Ibrahim, go and proclaim the calling for pilgrimage." So Ibrahim alayhi salatu wa salam, he then says, "Ya Allah, who will hear my voice? There is no one to give da'wah to. There is no one to call." Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said to Ibrahim, "O Ibrahim, your job is to listen to what I have to say. Your job is to make the adhan for hajj. Your job is to proclaim the hajj, conveying the message to insan, to mankind. That is my job. How they will receive the message, that is in the hands of Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala." And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed this ayah in the Quran, in Surah Al-Hajj. وَأَذِّنْ فِي النَّاسِ بِالْحَجِّ, and proclaim the calling to mankind for the pilgrimage, calling people to the house of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, this Kaaba that we are all in love with. When we speak about Mecca, we speak about Medina. Subhanallah, the first thing that comes to our heart is the love that we have for these two holy cities. So Ibrahim alayhi salatu wasalam, he climbs on the Kaaba and he makes this announcement: "O mankind, Allah has created this house and He is calling all of humanity to come and to perform the pilgrimage." He climbs up on the Kaaba Sharif and then he goes to Safa and Marwa, proclaiming the Hajj. Ibn Abbas radiyallahu anhu, under the tafsir of this ayah, وَأَذِّنْ فِي النَّاسِ بِالْحَجِّ, he says that when Ibrahim alayhi salatu wasalam, now bear in mind, 4,000 years ago, Ibrahim alayhi salam, he made this claim. He made this announcement, he made the adhan, calling people to perform Hajj. And Ibn Abbas, we all know who is Ibn Abbas. He is known as the Shaykh, the great alim who understood the Quran, who was granted the dua of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam when the Prophet of Allah said, he embraced him, he hugged him and said, "Allahumma faqqihu fi al-deen wa 'allimhu at-ta'wil." Oh Allah, grant Abdullah ibn Abbas good understanding of the deen and grant him good understanding of interpretation of the Quran. So this is the interpretation of Ibn Abbas of this ayah. And he says that when Ibrahim began calling the adhan, calling people for pilgrimage 4,000 years ago, even the mountains and the creation of Allah, they all humbled themselves. And every ruh that was created, every soul that was destined to perform hajj, they also received this announcement from Ibrahim alayhi salatu wasalam. And we all responded, for those who performed their hajj, "Labbaik Allahumma labbaik." In every city, this announcement that Ibrahim alayhi salatu wasalam made was taken to the heart of every human, subhanAllah. Now imagine 4,000 years ago, this is one gathering in humanity. The largest annual gathering in humanity is the Hajj. It is such an action, an amal, that is truly loved by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It is an amal that is loved by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Imagine, people come from all facets of life. People come, subhanallah, from all parts of the globe. Allah ta'ala says, وَأَذِّنْ فِي النَّاسِ بِالْحَجِّ يَأْتُوكَ رِجَالٍ. And proclaim the pilgrimage for man. You will see them coming on foot. And wallahi, to this very day, there are some people, there are some countries who actually walk to perform the hajj. Uzbekistan and similar countries, to this very day, people are walking to perform the hajj. People are going by boat, four-wheel drive, bicycle, walking, subhanallah, some people carrying others on their back to perform this ritual of hajj. World War I took place, World War II took place, but this is the only one of the unique signs of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that has never received any disturbance, and that is the hajj. Hajj has taken place from the time of Ibrahim alayhi salatu wasalam to this very day, subhanallah. Even in the time of Jahiliyyah, hajj took place. Subhanallah. Imagine now it has come to a stage. Hajj has become so popular that the government has to restrict the numbers of people coming for hajj. The government has to restrict the numbers of people from certain countries to cater for the people. This is Islam. If a person cannot find Islam just through this one sign of hajj, wallahi, they are blind. Imagine, people come, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَأَذِّنْ فِي النَّاسِ بِالْحَجِّ يَأْتُوكَ رِجَالًا وَعَلَى كُلِّ ضَامِرٍ. They will embark on every means of transport. عَلَى كُلِّ ضَامِرٍ here, it means even a weak animal. Even they would utilize a weak animal, an animal that's not capable, but just to get to hajj, they would utilize any more means of transportation to fulfill the rites of hajj. We are so fortunate in today's time. Allah has made it so easy for us. All we have to do is book our flight, and we're on a luxury plane, on a plane. You can go first class if you want. Business class if you can afford that. Or economy. Even economy is beautiful, subhanallah. Hajj, subhanallah. In today's time, people say it's so difficult, but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has been so merciful. Allah has been so kind. Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala has made it so easy for us to perform our hajj. My dear brothers and sisters, hajj is of the greatest signs of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And the Prophet of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said in a hadith, يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا كُتِبَ عَلَيْكُمُ الْحَجُّ فَحَجُّوا. O people of Iman, hajj has been prescribed upon us. It is compulsory. It is fard that we fulfill the obligation of hajj. فَحَجُّوا. So establish the pilgrimage. The Prophet of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has informed us of the great blessings that are associated with hajj. The Prophet of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam firstly mentions, the one who embarks on the journey of hajj, they are the guest of Allah. Why is it important for us to have this khutbah today? Why? Because mashallah, there are brothers, within a few days' time, they will be embarking on the greatest journey of their life. And that is the journey of hajj. To visit the grave of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. To make salam with Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. To visit the Kaaba Sharif. To make tawaf of the Kaaba. Allahu Akbar. So it is important as a community that we make dua for the Hujjaj. We acknowledge the Hujjaj. Why? Why as a community here at Slacks Creek or any masjid, why should we speak about hajj? Because we must remember our hujjaj who are leaving to go and perform their hajj. Because Allah, from all of people, they have chosen these people. They are the special people for 2016 because they have been chosen by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to embark on the journey of a lifetime, and that is hajj. So as Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, the people who are performing hajj, they are the guests. They are the respected guest of who? Of Allah, tabaraka wa ta'ala. The people of hajj, when they proclaim the talbiyah, لبيك اللهم لبيك لبيك لا شريك لك لبيك إن الحمد والنعمة لك والملك لا شريك لك. Every tree, every stone that hears this talbiyah, this labbaik Allah, they will testify for you on the day of Qiyamah that you have performed your pilgrimage. Imagine every tree, every stone that witness your talbiyah, subhanallah, that stone, that tree, that person will testify for you on the day of Qiyamah, subhanallah. When the Hujjaj gather at the plains of Arafah, as we know, Al-Hajj Arafah, if a person does not experience Arafah, there is no Hajj. There are two parts to Hajj. There is the wajibat and the rukun, the arkan. If a person misses a wajib, then he will have to pay the dam. He will have to sacrifice an animal. That is fine. For example, a person, he needs to be in the state of ihram, in the ihram, before performing his umrah. So before the miqat or at the miqat, he should wear his ihram. And let's just say he was sleeping on the plane and he forgot to put his ihram on. So this is a wajibat. Don't stress. You will pay the dam. You will do the sacrifice. But for example, if a person misses out on Arafah, he has lost his entire Hajj. He will need to come back the next year and re-perform his Hajj again. So imagine during the time of Arafah, when the Hujjaj, they gather at Arafah. This is the time where our Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, when you experience Arafah, make dua. And wallahi, speak to anyone who has performed their Hajj. And the dua that they made at Arafah, you can be the witness for that yourself. Did Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept those du'as? When you made du'a on Arafah, did Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala reject your du'a on this Mubarak field of Arafah? My dear brothers, when the Hujjaj gather on Arafah, Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala comes down to the lowest heavens. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and He says to the inhabitants of the heavens, look at my slaves. Look at my slaves, they are all dirty. They are tired, they are hungry. And they have come just for one purpose. Just to please me. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will say to the inhabitants of the heavens that I testify, all of you are witness that I have forgiven all of their sins. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says this. This is of the blessings of this amazing journey of Hajj. My dear brothers and sisters, never is shaitan more humiliated than on the day of Arafah. This is the day where shaitan is so humiliated. Shaitan is depressed. Shaitan is worried. Why? Because it is on this day that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, on Arafah, He showers His mercy. And shaitan can see all of this. And of course, any goodness for a believer is only the destruction for shaitan. The Hujjaj, every step that they take, the Prophet of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam says, their ranks in paradise are raised by one, every step that they take during the Hajj, and a sin is washed away. Imagine every step the Hajji makes, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala elevates his status, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is removing his sins. The Sahaba, when they perform Hajj with Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, the Prophet of Allah, while performing Hajj, he says to the Sahaba, O Sahaba, O my companions, be proud, be happy, for you are following in the footsteps of your father, Ibrahim, alayhi salatu wassalam. As for those who are throwing the jamarat, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is recording this for you. And as for the one who trims his hair during the Hajj, Nabi sallallahu alayhi wasallam says, for every hair that falls from the Hajji, while shaving his hair, his sins are forgiven. Subhanallah. Imagine every hair that falls, that you cut during the time of Hajj, when performing Umrah or Hajj, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is cleansing us. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is removing our sins, subhanallah. Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala, He praises Muzdalifah. We all know Muzdalifah. Huh? You say Muzdalifa, you see the biggest smile. They said, oh, it's not five stars. It's all stars, my friend. All, right? All stars. You know, there's no hotel. You sleep outside under the stars. That's what they say. Muzdalifa is an all-star hotel. Not five star, all stars. Why? Because you can see all the stars. Nabi Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala praises Muzdalifa in the Quran. فَإِذَا أَفَضْتُم مِّنْ عَرَفَاتٍ فَاذْكُرُوا اللَّهَ عِنْدَ الْمَشْعَرِ الْحَرَامِ وَاذْكُرُوهُ كَمَا هَدَاكُمْ. That when you complete your Arafah, then proceed to where? The sacred lands, referring to Muzdalifa. وَاذْكُرُوهُ كَمَا هَدَاكُمْ. Praise Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Why? Because He has guided us. Subhanallah. When the Hajji, he performs the Tawaf al-Ifada. The Tawaf al-Ifada is the Tawaf that allows a person to complete his Hajj. This is the final Tawaf. It is now time to go home. The Prophet of Allah sallallahu alayhi wasallam says, after a person performs the Tawaf al-Ifada, he is like a newborn baby, subhanAllah. Free from sin. That child, when it's born, it is clean. That child is free of all faults. That child is free of all sin. Likewise, a person who performs the Tawaf al-Ifada and he performs his Hajj, as the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam says, "Man hajja lillah." The one who performs Hajj for the sake of Allah, فَلَمْ يَرْفُثْ وَلَمْ يَفْسُقْ رَجَعَكَ يَوْمٍ وَلَدَتْهُ أُمُّهُ. He will be like a newborn baby, subhanAllah. Free from all sins. My dear brothers, what we want to achieve is a Hajj mabrur, a accepted Hajj. And the Prophet of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, لَيْسَ لَهُ جَزَاءٌ إِلَّا الْجَنَّةِ. There is no reward for a person who performs his Hajj except paradise. There can be no justification for granting this person reward except paradise. Allahumma ja'alna minhum. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept from us. The Prophet of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam also referred to the Hajj as a form of striving. It is a form of jihad. Right? It is a form of striving. One lady came to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and she said, oh Prophet of Allah, I want to strive in your path. I want to strive in your path. For your sake, the Prophet of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam says that the jihad, the striving for the weak and the woman, it is the performing of Hajj. It is the performing of Hajj. Subhanallah. Look at the status that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given to the Hujjaj. My dear respected brothers and elders, the last benefit of Hajj, and of course there are many, many blessings, but many of us don't realize that when a person performs his Hajj, one of the greatest ways of increasing your rizq is by performing your Hajj. In today's time, what do we say? You ask people, brother, why haven't you done your Hajj? Oh, brother, you come up with all the excuses under the sun. And in reality, we do not believe in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala enough to understand that the Prophet of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam made it so clear that when you perform your pilgrimage, Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala increases your rizq. Subhanallah. Wallahi, speak to those people who are a living testimony who have performed their Hajj. Don't take my word. Speak to the Hujjaj. Wallahi, inna Allah la yukhlifu al-mi'ad. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala never breaks His promise. By performing your Hajj, this will increase your rizq. My dear brothers and sisters, one of the reasons why we are speaking about the topic of Hajj, not only to congratulate our Hujjaj and to wish them well and to make dua for them, but to bring to our attention the importance of performing the Hajj. What we need to remember is Hajj is one of the fundamentals of Islam. It is one of the five pillars of Islam. It is the foundation of a believer. We need to understand that when a person has the means and he has the physical ability, it becomes wajib, compulsory upon you to perform your Hajj. And the Prophet of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam has mentioned very stern ahadith for a person who has the means and he does not perform his Hajj. Wallahi, my dear brothers, like the time for salah comes in, we need to pray our salah, sahih. When zakah is due, we must pay our zakah. When fasting, when the month of Ramadan comes, we must fast. Likewise, when a believer has the money, has sufficient wealth to embark on the journey of Hajj, it becomes wajib, fard, compulsory upon you and I to perform our Hajj. It is the pillar of Islam. We cannot leave this dunya without performing our Hajj, my dear brothers and sisters. Many of us use the excuse and say, yeah, Sheikh, one person came to me a few weeks ago. He said, Imam, Sheikh. I said, have you done your Hajj yet? He says, no, I'm not pious enough. You're not pious enough. Is that your lame excuse? You are not pious enough. Is not Hajj the opportunity to turn your life around? Are we not scared of the angel of death coming to us and removing our ruh and us leaving this world without performing this obligation of Hajj? Do we not fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? This is the, as they say, it is a journey of a lifetime. Why? Because the time for Hajj, it is the time where we dedicate our entire life to Allah. This is the time to remove those barriers that exist between us and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to change our lives, to do the right thing. Many people who go on Hajj, and wallahi, they come back as new people. They come back changing their entire lives around, subhanAllah. And that is one of the benefits of Hajj. When you see the Kaaba and you make dua, you just cry, subhanAllah. When you go and meet Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, when you go to the grave of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, your iman increases, subhanAllah. You think about what sacrifice our Prophet, Habib al-Mustafa sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and the Sahaba went through for us to extract the fruits of Hajj. We are so fortunate. There is no hard work on our behalf. Our Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, the Anbiya alayhi musallatu wasallam, they did all the hard work. Hajj has been made so easy for us, my dear brothers. If you have not made your intention, my dear brothers, wallahi, before buying that fancy car, before buying that fancy house, fulfill your obligation with Allah. First thing you do, inshallah, to end off, make your intention. وَمَن يَتَّقِ اللَّهِ يَجْعَلْ لَهُ مَخْرَجًا. Whoever has the taqwa of Allah, Allah will make a way out for you. Start saving, open a saving account. Save $50 a week or $100 a week. Put that aside, make your intention. And if you are to pass away, at least you had the intention. You were making the effort. I urge you, wallahi, my dear brothers, this is a journey we must make an effort for. Go out of your way to fulfill this obligation of Hajj. I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for those people who have not performed the Hajj, may Allah make it easy for them. May Allah invite them. And we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for all the Hujjaj that are leaving from Queensland and Australia, may Allah protect them. May Allah accept their Hajj. May Allah make their journey easy for them. We also request, inshallah, all the Hujjaj that are going from the Slats Creek Masjid or who are present here today to please remember us in your du'as, inshallah. Make du'a for yourself, for your family. Make du'a for the ummah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and convey our dearest salams to our beloved Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Subhanakallahumma wa bihamdika. Ashhadu an la ilaha illa anta nastaghfiruka wa natubu ilayhi.